Good morning, students. Now today we will continue with the chapter The Ashes That Made Trees Bloom. We have completed first part of this chapter. Now we will continue with the second part of this chapter. So we will start from this stanza. The train drew near. One tall, competent man marched ahead, crying out to the people by the way, "Get down on your knees, get down on your knees." And everyone kneeled down while the procession was passing. Now what happened? Along with the daimyo, there was a man whose job was to say again and again, "Get down on your knees, get down on your knees." And everyone kneeled down while the train of the daimyo passed. Suddenly, the leader of the band caught sight of the aged man up in the tree. He was about to call out to him in an angry tone, but seeing he was such an old fellow, he pretended not to notice him and passed him by. Now, as I told you that the old kind man climbed up withered cherry tree. Now he was noticed by the leader of the van. He was just about to call him in an angry tone, but then he thought that he was such an old fellow, so he pretended as if he has noticed or if he has not seen him and passed him by. So when the daimyo's palanquin drew near, the old man, taking a pinch of ashes from his basket, scattered it over the tree. In a moment it burst into blossom. Now meaning of palanquin is given. Its meaning is royal van cup, right? Now what happened when the daimyo's van drew near? What the old man did? He took a pinch of ashes from his basket and sprinkled those ashes on that withered tree, on that dry tree. And in a moment that dry tree was burst into blossom, into flowers, and into pink flowers, right? The delighted daimyo ordered the train to be stopped and got out to see the wonder. Now, as we know that wonder was created by the ashes of the mill. He was very happy. Daimyo was very happy and he ordered the train to be stopped. And he got out of his train to see how the magic happened. Calling the old man to him, he thanked him and ordered presents of silk robes, sponge cake, fans, and other rewards to be given him. Now the daimyo was so impressed that he gave so many rewards to that old man. He even invited him to his castle. So the old man went gleefully home to share his joy with his dear old wife. Now, along with giving so many rewards, daimyo also invited the old man to his kingdom, to his castle. So the old man was so happy and he went to his home and shared his happiness with his dear old wife. But when the greedy neighbor heard of it, he took some of the magic ashes and went out on the highway. Now, when the greedy neighbor couple also heard about the magic and also heard that daimyo rewarded the old kind man. On hearing this, what he did? He took some of the magic ashes with him and he went out on the highway. Then, there he waited until a daimyo's train came along, and instead of kneeling down like the crowd, he climbed a withered cherry tree. Now he also copied the old man and he also climbed the dry tree instead of kneeling down. When the daimyo herself was almost directly under him, he threw a handful of ashes over the tree, which did not change a particle. Now when daimyo came near, what that wicked man did? He threw a handful of ashes over the tree, but nothing happened. There was no magic this time. The wind blew the fine dust in the noses and eyes of the daimyo and his wife. such sneezing and choking. It spoiled all the pomp and dignity of the procession. Now the opposite happened. Instead of blooming the tree, the ashes went to the noses and eye of the daimyo and his wife. The man whose business it was to cry, "Get down on your knees," seized the old fool by the collar, dragged him from the tree and tumbled him and his ash basket into the ditch by the road. Now, the man whose business was to say, business means whose job was to say again and again, "Get down on your knees," again and again. He caught the old fool and he dragged him down from the tree. Then, beating him soundly, he left him for dead. And that man beated the wicked old man so badly and left him for dead. Thus, the wicked old man died in the mud. But the kind friend of the dog dwelt in peace and plenty. And both he and his wife lived to green old age. Now when the man whose job was to cry again and again, "Get down on your knees," he brought that wicked man from the tree, and he beat him so badly that he died in the mud. But the kind friend of the dog was in peace, was in living an active and healthy life. So children, this chapter teaches us people are known by their deeds. Just as a tree is known by its leaves and fruit, people and animals will all be kind to us if we are kind to them. Okay? Thank you.